certain amount of vaginal discharge is normal. It can occur any time in a woman's life, but functionally starts with puberty. But one day you may wake up to yellow, green or greyish white discharge and wonder, what is this now? So today let's discuss abnormal vaginal discharge, different colors of vaginal discharge, why and when it happens, and how to tackle them. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Womb to Super Womb. I am Dr. Samata with you on this journey towards a healthier you. In my last video, I spoke about normal vaginal discharge, excessive normal discharge, otherwise called leucorrhea, and a few tips to deal with white discharge. Today, let's talk about abnormal colors, smell of vaginal discharge, and what might cause them. Before I get the ball rolling, I want you all to understand that there is clear distinction between normal and abnormal vaginal discharge in terms of its characteristics such as quantity, color, smell, consistency, age of the woman, time of its appearance, and reason for its appearance. Having the knowledge of this can tell you if your discharge is abnormal, so you can seek medical care and you can keep yourself worry-free. So, first let's know the various reasons for abnormal discharge. Whenever you come across abnormal colored smelly discharge, the first thing that should come to your mind is some sort of infection. Infection is the most common cause. When infectious organisms like fungus or bacteria gain access to vagina, one of the symptoms exhibited is discharge. The second reason for such abnormal discharge could be atrophic changes. What is atrophy? Atrophy means decrease in cell mass or wasting, which can happen as a result of aging, as we see in postmenopausal women. Such women have thin white discharge due to estrogen deficiency. Estrogen deficiency causes vaginal thinning and dryness. This could further lead to irritation and inflammation of vagina, resulting in scanty, thin white discharge. But usually in such women, vaginal irritation is more prominent than discharge. Third reason could be foreign body, like a forgotten tampon or pessary in the vagina. Many a times, women come to the hospital with foul-smelling pus discharge days after delivery or vaginal operations with forgotten tampon in the vagina, which would have caused severe infection. Although this sounds unusual, it happens way too often. Then, there are chemical causes. Use of douches, latex condoms with spermicides or lubricants, or contamination of vagina with urine or stools in women suffering from a condition called fistula, or new growth like fibroid, polyp, or even genital malignancy can also cause abnormal vaginal discharge. Now let's know which color and smell of vaginal discharge is associated with which infection. First, yellow-green frothy discharge. This is seen in one of the most common sexually transmitted infections called vaginal trichomoniasis, caused by a parasite. In this, a woman may have yellowish-green frothy discharge with other symptoms like soreness and itchiness in the private part. She may feel stinging and burning sensation while passing urine. What happens if this condition is neglected or not treated? Firstly, the woman could spread infection to her partner. Such an infection can persist for months to years, and the woman has high chances of getting infected with other sexually transmitted infections. When there are multiple infections of the reproductive organs and fallopian tubes majorly, it becomes pelvic inflammatory disease. This could possibly become the reason for a woman to have problems with conception and continuation of pregnancy. You must be wondering if this infection can affect an unborn child. Yes, a pregnant woman who isn't treated for trichomoniasis might have an early water break or a premature delivery due to this infection. The baby might be born with low birth weight, and in rare cases, this infection may pass to the baby during vaginal delivery. Next, curdy white discharge in flakes or cottage cheese-like discharge with itchiness in private parts. This may happen when you have yeast infection. In other words, a vaginal fungal infection called vaginal candidiasis or candidal vulvovaginitis. Vagina normally contains bacteria and yeast cells, but when there is overgrowth of candida, it causes intense itching, swelling, and irritation in the private part. This is not considered as a sexually transmitted infection. Although sexual contact can spread it, women who are not sexually active may also develop vaginal candidiasis. This infection is quite common in women who are diabetic, women taking a lot of pills like antibiotics, birth control pills, women on hormonal therapy, and also in pregnant women. A pregnant woman who has vaginal candidiasis is likely to pass on the infection to her baby at the time of vaginal delivery. So it is always better to see a doctor, get treated as soon as you see the first symptom. Next, coming to grey-white discharge. Grey-white discharge with fishy odor and usually non-itchy is a sign of bacterial vaginosis. How does one get bacterial vaginosis or BV? Anything that brings about change in the vaginal pH may cause bacterial vaginosis. Any reason for hormonal changes such as menses, pregnancy, or menopause may bring about change in the pH of vagina. Or any imbalance in the amount of good versus bad bacteria in the vagina may change the pH. Although every woman goes through these, not all suffer. That's because of one's immunity. You should build good immunity through healthy diet, exercise, and personal hygiene to keep infections at bay. Probiotics play an important role in the upkeeping of good bacteria in the vagina. Add yogurt and buttermilk to your diet as they are good sources of probiotics. Now we come to yellow discharge. Yellow discharge is seen in another sexually transmitted infection called gonorrhea or the clap. This is a slightly serious issue where the patient may have other symptoms like pain in the tummy or pelvic pain, pain during intercourse, a sensation of burning and stinging while passing urine. These infections that I mentioned, especially gonorrheal infection, if not treated, is more likely to cause pelvic inflammatory disease and may eventually become a potential reason for infertility. The female as well as the male partner should be treated in such cases. Next, yellow colored pus-like discharge with strong smell is characteristic of chlamydial infection. Along with yellow pus-like discharge, the other symptoms that could be seen in chlamydial infections are pain during intercourse, burning and itchy sensation while urinating. Chlamydia is actually a very sneaky infection. Most of the times, it may not cause any symptom, but can be an indirect cause for infertility. Some women experience thick white mucoid discharge almost every day without any other symptom. This could be a sign of cervicitis or sign of inflammation of cervix or could be cervical erosion. Are such infections curable and how can we tackle them? Yes, they are curable and the treatment needs to be offered to both the woman and her partner. A course of antibiotics is given and during the course of the treatment, the couple has to avoid sexual contact until both become free from infection. As soon as you come across such abnormal colored discharge, with or without smell, please visit your gynecologist who would ask you to get a few tests. Antibiotics will be generally prescribed orally and locally as per the need. Ayurveda scriptures have elaborately explained a number of local treatment modalities like vulval and vaginal wash, tampons dipped in medicated formulations and placed in vagina, vaginal suppositories are prescribed which are prepared with medicinal plants. These help to cleanse the vulva and vagina, get rid of the infectious organisms, maintain normal vaginal flora and normal vaginal pH. What should you do while undergoing treatment for abnormal discharge? Firstly, finish out the course of treatment prescribed by your doctor, even if you become symptom-free in a day or two. Take diet or supplements containing vitamin C, vitamin E, and probiotics to improve your immunity. Local hygiene can prevent and cure such infections big time and quickly. Do watch my video on vaginal discharge part 1 to know preventive hygiene tips for vulval and vaginal care. What is it that you have to avoid in such situations? Avoid intercourse as you are likely to spread or receive infection from your partner. Avoid tampons, menstrual cups that could possibly introduce bacteria and flare up infection until you are completely cured. Is it normal to have discharge in pregnancy? Yes, pregnant women will have some amount of discharge throughout pregnancy. The discharge that is copious, thin, sticky, and white in color is normal. This is because of exfoliation of cells caused by high estrogen levels during pregnancy. The other type of discharge which a pregnant woman comes across in labor is watery discharge or water break. The woman feels water gushing just like urine but coming out of vagina, completely wetting her garments. This is due to rupture of amniotic membranes and leakage of amniotic fluid that's present around the baby in the womb. This is a sign of labor and shows that a woman is on the verge of delivering her baby. Water break can happen prematurely, what we call as premature rupture of membranes. Water break can also happen in miscarriage and preterm labor. I will be talking about each of this in my upcoming videos. Then comes red discharge. Are all red color discharges related to your periods? Can all red color discharge be taken lightly? What do bright red, pinkish, brown discharge mean in pregnancy? Let's discuss all of these in my next video. Stay healthy and stay tuned. Thank you.